ओके संदीप, सो व्हेन यू क्रिएट अ डिस्क फॉर विंडोज मशीन, ओके लेट्स सी, यू हैव टू सर्वर हेयर, लाइक वन इज फॉर द विंडोज एंड वन इज फॉर द लिनक्स। व्हेन यू क्रिएट अ डिस्क फॉर विंडोज मशीन, व्हेन यू क्रिएट अ एक्सटर्नल डिस्क फॉर विंडोज मशीन, देन वी नीड टू फॉर्मेट इट एंड इनिशियलाइज इट अकॉर्डिंगली टू द जीपीटी और द एमबीआर। वी नीड टू गो इन टू द कंप्यूटर मैनेजमेंट, देन वी कैन अटेस्ट इट सक्सेसफुली।
This has been tested very well. We understood
यस
Linux, same disk we tried to attach in Linux.
या द
Not at
सेम
all.
थिंग, द सेम थिंग वी कैन वी डू इन द लाइनेक्स मशीन। वी क्रिएट अ डिस्क एंड अटैच्ड विद द लाइनेक्स फाइल सिस्टम। सो दे हैव फाइल सिस्टम लाइक EXT4 एंड EXFS। दे हैव द फाइल सिस्टम इज लाइनेक्स, ऑल्सो आई हैव द फाइल सिस्टम EXT4। दीज आर द टू फाइल सिस्टम और मे बी मोर। सो we need to format the disk into this file system, then we can only able to attach with this Linux server. Okay, so how to do that? Let's see. Go to the console and launch a Linux machine here and connect with that. Okay. Yeah. So first go to the portal. Let me verify. Okay, so I am going to create a resources virtual machine, Linux virtual machine, and attach a disk to this machine. Okay, so let me go into the my resource group, and in my resource group I want to create a virtual machine. Like I'm going to create a Ubuntu server. Okay, and we can also
Red
create,
Hat machine also be same.
yes, Red Hat machine we can also create.
Let us go with Red Hat latest.
Yeah, I'm selecting Red Hat 8.1. Okay, create and pay as you go. Virtual machine name, like set my first Linux. US East and security type standard, all the things I left as.
And also, what is that Azure Spot instance? What does that mean actually?
What?
Azure Spot instance, one checkbox is there, right?
Yeah, let me check it.
Yeah, below images.
Below left side, come down. Come down again. Ah, yes, there.
Azure Spot instance, what is it exactly?
Let me check it. It is on the it provide a deep discount, more than 90%. It's provide only the up to 90%, because if Azure have available some instances, so they will provide you up to for up to 90% discount. But they can take it back whenever it required. It is risky to create with Azure Spot instance. Okay. You can find the document. You can use the Azure Spot virtual machine, but machines allowed to take advantage for unused capacity at significant cost saving means you can take it up to 90% discount, but at any point in the time when Azure need the capacity back, the Azure infrastructure will evict Azure Spot virtual machine. That means whenever Azure Cloud required that machine, they can take it back from you. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Okay.
Got it?
Yes.
So, for connecting with the Linux machine, in Windows machine, we do a RDP tool. We connected with the RDP tool, but in the Linux machine, they have the shell access or the terminal access. That's why we want a SSH public key or the password. We can use it through the password also, but generally we need a SSH key for it. So first create a SSH key over here. Write down this username on the notepad. This is the by default username for Linux machine. It is also an interview question that what is the default username for a Linux virtual machine in Azure Cloud. And in AWS, the default username is EC2-user. This is the default username in AWS and this is default username in Azure Cloud. Okay. So let's create a new key pair. Key pair means we need a key to decrypt this security and connect with that. Key pair value means that you when we create a key, what happens when we create a key? Like I have one key here. When you are on the Azure portal, let's say you are on the Azure portal and here you are the user. Here you are a user on your laptop. So when you create a key, that means it will create a two key means one key pair. One key pair you have downloaded it here and one key pair Azure have saved it to, and when you connected with that machine, then they are matching both the keys same or not, then connection is accepted and then you can connect with that. Got it?
Yes, but can we able to see this now, right?
Yeah, we can able to see right now. Okay, so it is asking me generate a new key pair. Okay, so I'm going to create a new key pair. Key pair name is my first Linux key. I am also change this name. Azure Linux VM. Okay. SSH port in RDP, there is a port number 3809 by default on, but for the SSH port number 22. It is also an interview question. Port number 22 works on the SSH and SSH works on the port number 22. Next, for the disk. We set everything default, and once the machine is launched, then we create a disk and attach with that. Next, on the networking, everything set as default.
Actually, in advanced tab, we found something like.
Yeah, let me go to the advanced tab and for. Yeah, if you have. And here you can install your extensions. If you have custom extension or post deployment configuration, we can install your extension over here. We will see these things into the same session. Okay, how to install.
We found something called like host group, capacity reservation group, proximity placement. What are those actually?
What? Can you please repeat it?
Host group, capacity reservation group. Yeah, let me keep it in charge.
Where it is?
Just scroll down. They're not aware. It is there, right? Host group and capacity.
Host group means, read this, if you have dedicated host, means if you have a physical server with our data center, then you can create a host group over here and merge with that and select the capacity according to that reservation group and all the things. But in the
okay. You are using your dedicated host for our machines, for our VMs, in that case only host.
Yes, you can read this as your dedicated host allow you to provision and manage a physical server with our data center that are dedicated to your Azure subscription. That means when you use this service as your dedicated host, means you own a complete server machine.
Okay.
You own a complete machine. No one can deploy a machine into that server. You are only able to connect with that and you can do anything with that. Okay.
What is proximity group then?
These are the proximity for the policy. We have no item available in the here. We will see these things into the next. So let me complete the Linux once and then we will clear with you. Okay. And we also do the extension for post deployment configuration. We will see in this session. Okay. Let me create it once. Next, management, and then everything set as default. Review and create. So Azure don't have the Linux machine. They are taking by the procomputers.com. They are owned from another third party vendor. That's why it is not covered in the free tier. You can see here Red Hat Enterprises 8.1 by procomputers.com. That means procomputers.com gives Linux machine to the Microsoft Azure cloud, and you own that machine for these charges. Got it?
Yeah, good.
Create. We need to download the key pair. Download private key and create resource. So Sandeep, let me know which tool you are using to connect with your Linux machine.
Yeah, PuTTY only.
PuTTY only. Okay. So you have experience in the PuTTY?
Yes, we have.
Okay. So, but I use something different. Let me once create the machines, then I will show you how to add a machine into that. Okay. I am using Termius tool. It is very fast and eco-friendly with another tool. You can save all the sessions over here or all the machines over here. First, let create the virtual machine. In PuTTY, you need to change that file to another format like PPK. I'm correct or not?
This key thing, I'm not aware in Linux how to do it.
Yeah, okay. So in PuTTY, let's download the PuTTY once. What we actually need into the PuTTY?
The downloaded key pem is like authorized key.
Yeah, authorized. It is authorized key, but we need to convert into the pem to PPK. We need to install two software here, PuTTY and PuTTY Gen. There are two software for connect with the Linux machine. For the convert the PEM file, we need to convert that machine, convert that file to PPK. PuTTY Gen is here. So once we need to load that file, the file is here. You can select all file and then you got my first Linux VM. Open and it is converted, saved privately. Now you can see my Linux. Save that and cross it. Now you are able to connect with the PuTTY tool. So I'm using right now PuTTY. Yes, you need to enter here the host name. Host name means your server IP. Go back to the panel and see the server IP over here. Deployment is still in process. Once it created, we are able to connect with that machine. But if you are create a Linux machine into the AWS, it will deploy it within minutes. It is more faster than the Azure cloud. AWS is best for the open source. Go to resources. Yeah, let's go to the resources. And here you see your machine public IP. We need to copy this public IP and here paste it. Load the key into the SSH and auth. Browse the key and paste it here. My Linux. Open it and try to connect with that session. Accept once. Yeah, so here we need to enter the username. Default username is Azure user. Now we are able to connect with that machine. Okay. In RDP, in Windows machine, in Windows machine, you can connect single machine at a time only. I'm correct?
Yeah, yes,
sir. Yes. Yeah. You can connect single machine at a time only, or you are not able to connect same machine with multiple times. You can able to do only the single login. But in the Linux machine, multi-login, multi-user means you can connect thousands of users at a single time. Okay, you can see I am connected with that machine with PuTTY, and I am also going to connect same machine with another client, with another SSH client. I have tool, Termius tool. In Termius tool, to connect with a machine, you need to create a host over here, plus new host. Then we set a label, my Azure machine, and paste the IP over here. This is my machine IP. Username is Azure user, and load the key, plus key and file. Now here I can connect my machine with PAM also, and also with the PPK file. So let's connect with the PPK file, open and save it. Saved. Now try to connect with that machine. Connect via SSH. Add and continue. Now you can see I'm able to connect with that machine with two clients over here, or I can connect with multiple clients. Got it? If I have multiple user in that machine, then I can create and connect with that. Got it? Hello, Sandeep, do you have any confusion or query here? So we can discuss right now.
No, and we are clear of this.
Clear? Okay. Yes. So let's connect a disk with that. Okay. Close the PuTTY and let's go to the back to the panel, and here in the disk, I'm going to connect a disk here, create and attach a new disk. Yeah, I'm going to create. Disk name is my external disk. I select 10 GB and got it. I attached this successfully, but not done from the Linux side. The disk is created from the Azure side, but it is not successfully attached to the machine because we need to format that. let's go back to the Linux machine over here, and to check the disk into the Linux, we have a command df-h. So you can see we have only the 30 GB. We have only the 30 GB right now, and you are not able to see the 10 GB resources over here. Okay, and you also got for the temporary storage, 8 GB is here, as we have in the Windows, 8 GB temporary storage and 30 GB for the usage. So how to see that the how to see this disk? We have a command lsblk to see the complete disk information. You can see 30 GB is here and 7 GB temporary storage is here, and SDC is 10 GB is attached with that, but it is not formatted. So we need to format this disk and attach with that. Okay. And mount this disk on a folder or a directory. So let's go to the super user, sudo su. So I am a super user right now. Let's format this disk. mkfs, this is command for the format. Which format I am using? ext4, mkfs.ext4. My device name is devsdc. devsdc. Enter. Sorry, mkfs. mkfs.ext4, devsdc. So my file system is assigned to the particular disk, this disk. You can see file system assigned with the UID and blocked. Okay, now the disk is successfully formatted with the Linux file system. Now we are going to attach with that. We need to create a directory over here. mkdir, first go to the root volume, create a directory over here, mkdir. I'm going to create a directory like cloud akshay. Now you can see df-h is still not connected with that machine, so you are not able to see 10 GB here. Now connect with that, mount on the drive. Mount the drive on that folder. Mount. Disk name is devsdc. And on which folder? Cloud Akshay. So you can see mount is successfully done. And let's check df-h. Yeah, you can see 10 GB is mounted on the Cloud Akshay. Got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
If I am creating some files over here in Cloud Akshay, like touch, I create multiple files over here like that, anything, ABCDXYZ, something. Okay. Then these files are written to my disk, not on the volume, not on the root volume. These files are directly written to my disk, external disk. Okay. If I unmount this disk and attached with the another virtual machine, then it is same. Got it? When you attach this disk to another machine, no need to format it again. If you format it, you will lost your data. you no need to do format it again, and you can directly mount with that machine, mount with the particular machine, mount with the particular Linux machine. Got it? For the Linux disk, you are not able to connect with the Windows machine. If you want to attach a Linux disk to a Windows machine, you are not able to connect with that.
Okay.
Because the file system is different, that's why you are not able to connect. Okay. In Linux, there is no C drive, D drive, E drive. There is only a directory. It's work only on the directory. Okay. Is it clear for you or not?
Clear. What is the touch command which you have used on the purpose?
What?
You have used touch and all, right? Just now you
touch.
Have used.
Okay. Touch is using to create a empty files. Touch is a command to create a empty files.
Okay. In CloudAxia folder, you have created some files.
Yeah. Okay. In CloudAxia folder, I have created these files. You can see with the ls.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.